Good morning, guys. Back again on the Triumph Bonneville, and we're heading down to the annual Oaks Park picnic for the Oregon Vintage Motorcyclists Club. This is one of my favourite events. As you can see, the weather's not too great to begin with, but it's supposed to get a little warm later on and dry, thankfully. So as you saw, Dave has just arrived on his Commando Interstate. He's been fitting a new belt to his belt drive, and so this is him doing a test ride since he fitted that just recently. I'd be better if I could remember how the gearbox works on this.
I may have tried to shift over here a couple times.
Yeah, me too.
At least the rain stopped.
Yeah. I spent all day on the Norton yesterday, and the different gearbox patterns, so made a few little mistakes. Yeah, I love this event. In particular because most guys, I would say 95% of the guys, ride their bikes to this event. And the location is always very interesting as well. It's in a historical amusement park just south of Portland. This event usually starts, I think officially, at 10 o'clock, but as you know, I like to get somewhere a little earlier, and so it's about 8:30. Such a nice scene in the morning, you know, it's nice and quiet and peaceful, and the first few guys are showing up on their bikes, and it's just got a more of a relaxed feel, because it just gets a little bit busier later on. So I particularly enjoy that, and poor old Dave is very patient with me to come with me early. This isn't the same, is it? I guess we're in that corral.
Yes, we are. Is it gonna park by the fence though?
Yeah, I don't know if we can. It looks like that's all gone now. It's actually a road.
There's a walking space there.
I'll go and ask him.
Okay.
Morning. Hi there. Do we have to be in the corral for the bikes?
This is for the classic show?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's in there.
Can we go up against the railing or no?
Huh?
We can't go up against that railing, right?
No.
Okay, all right. That was helpful. What do you think I'm on, dude? Oh well, get a good place in the corral. Morning, John.
I saw that you just hit salt.
And I had my license. He stops me, and I got off, and I took the kid.
No, no, he wasn't recording.
First year, he stepped off the bike, and I turned to look at him. He's coming around, he rode in the flying section around the motorhome.
Yeah, it's one of the happiest days of my life.
Every time I Harley, I'm real quick. Yeah, every time. Do you go through the pants?
This is what you want, Steve.
So she's.
That's a shiny one.
Yeah. He rode his Prof Superior up to Bastion.
Take those off and balance that.
I actually took it. I just pictured that, you know, bus ride. And I could see this.
Thank you. See if he can do a wheelie.
Yeah, we'll try it.
Wheelie! Wheelie!
That is fantastic, that bike. Oh yeah, I'm parked to this, next to this little old thing. AC Cobra. Some really nice bikes there. What was your favourite? I can tell you what mine was, and that's that Velo set with the Avon fairing. Just so cool. Some other close contenders as well. Some beautiful restored bikes, some original bikes, old and new, eclectic. Very, very nice. I always like to see the Triumphs. And I've left my turn signal on. But most importantly, it's just great to meet all the guys that are in the vintage motorcycle community. There's just tons of guys there. I really enjoy spending time with them, hanging out. And I want to say thank you very much indeed to Jim and John and Sam and everyone who was involved in all the work that it takes to cater for a club event like that. It's a lot of work. I don't think they got a break and got much chance to look around the bike, so thank you all very much. Really appreciate it.